So the title of the poster is ACICS, Assured Cloud Platforms for Industrial Cyber Physical Systems. My name is Cristina Seceleanu, and this is joint work with Eduard Enoiu, Moris Behnam, Gabriele Capannini, Jan Carlson, Kristina Lundqvist, and Séverine Sentilles, all from Mellardale University. Okay, so with the emergency of Industry 4.0 and the cloud technologies and its benefits, increasingly many manufacturers of cyber physical systems are lured into distributing their cyber part, which is the one dealing with data and communication technologies, into the cloud as well as on device. So splitting the cyber part that once was only on device also to the cloud. So they distributed this part to achieve smart mobility and smart products, and also to take advantage of computational power, storage power, and so create scalable solutions. While this happens, in general, cyber-physical system manufacturers need two types of clouds. They need to actually have a way of storing critical information for their business and manipulate that, retrieve and upload information and data with respect to their operations in an efficient way. And they also need to access services that are cross-cutting. So, for instance, maintenance. Data history, histograms. So these kind of things give rise to architectures that use hybrid clouds. So they use a combination of industrial clouds, which are private, and they are dedicated entirely to a specific business. They provide the same agility and scalability, but also they should provide a way of undisclosing critical information. With the public clouds that actually are the ones that we all know, Amazon Web Services, Google Clouds, Microsoft Azure, that can be used for non-sensitive operations. One can view the cloud as a platform where industry or users upload data, store it, and analyze it, but also use various services that their operation can benefit from. So if we assume an infrastructure that actually connects smart devices, then to realize a cloud-based industrial cyber-physical system, one needs to come with a cloud infrastructure that actually contains a lot of data centers on which virtual machines run and on which various services are deployed. And these various services use data that is produced in the network and can be accessed, but in places that are not known a priori. So this data is huge. It has various types of characteristics, can be real-time, can be non-real-time, it can have various formats, so it can be highly unstructured. In this setting, we have, since a cyber-physical systems control real-world operations and real-world systems, any kind of delay in from accessing this data and gathering it to its analysis and decision-making can actually impact very seriously the safety of the system with respect to property and human lives. So therefore, timeliness as well as data structuring and data modeling with respect to interoperability and consistency are two aspects that need to be taken into consideration in order to boost the dependability of such hybrid cloud platforms for cyber physical systems. So why do we use this assured name in our title? Because from the investigation of the state of the art, we infer the fact that hybrid cloud platforms in general miss dependability guarantees, especially to the dimensions that I just mentioned, data interoperability and data dependency and timeliness. So time predictability of such platforms is not ensured by existing solutions. So consistency of data, security of data also, because having a combination of private and public cloud means that in the same ecosystem means that there is the need of undisclosing critical information from one company, let's say, to the other, or from one domain to the other. So security of data, especially data privacy, is very important. Timing and safety constraints, as I mentioned, and also a way of ensuring at least at the abstract level, at design time, but also at runtime, that these quality of service attributes are met. So why a new approach? So now we talked about why assured clouds and why a new approach? Because the state of the art in multi-cloud environments for cyber physical systems provides solutions indeed, but all these solutions miss some of the aspects that I just mentioned. So they investigate the quality of service-based service selection for multi-cloud environments, but they do not consider the interplay of private and public clouds. Also, they do not consider data privacy and consistency models, and they do not consider the dependency between data and quality of service attributes. Also, there is a lack of timing predictability of virtualized infrastructures. So as we saw, services are deployed on virtual machines where they can be accessed by applications, by physical machines. And such algorithms for quantifying low-level resources of interest that would actually give a runtime view of the accessing and using such resources are missing in the literature, and such a runtime view would actually impact how these applications should be moved or migrated, perhaps from one virtual machine to the other dynamically, depending on the fingerprint of the operation at runtime, at some point in time. On top of this, there are some approaches for formal modeling and analysis framework for cloud services and cloud infrastructures, but these approaches do not look at safety, timing, and data privacy together, which we would like to address, because we identify that these are three dimensions or three quality of service that actually, once guaranteed, would boost the dependability of such platforms. They do not consider the integrated quality of service, and they do not integrate behavioral modeling of machines. For instance, if you think robots moving in on a factory floor with communication protocols that are secured and abstracted virtualization. So therefore, we thought, okay, there is room for work here. So we asked, we posed a main research question of this project: how to boost the dependability of cloud-based platforms for industrial cyber-physical applications with respect to the three quality of service attributes that I emphasized: timeliness, safety, and data security, especially data privacy. So made some hypotheses, and we said, okay, such a dependability can be boosted if we are able to structure this data, which is huge and which is provided in different places in the network by different devices or companies, and they have different characteristics: non-real-time, hard real-time, soft real-time, non-real-time, and develop methods to integrate them such that we guarantee their data consistency and data privacy. That's one way of boosting dependability. Another way is to provision resources and services in the virtualized environment with the guaranteed quality of service, especially timing predictability. And the third way is to achieve a high degree of assurance via formal modeling and verification or analysis approaches that take adequate integrated models into account. I mean, models that actually cater for safety, timeliness, and data privacy, but also that look into various cloud deployment scenarios in an abstracted manner, take them into consideration such that such scenarios can be compared, and for instance, counter examples can be generated and fed back such that new deployment scenarios are computed. So our overall goal is to provide models, methods and tools for a substantial increase of dependability of cloud-based platforms for industrial physical systems via consistency, data privacy and data interoperability, timing predictability of using shared virtual resources, and a framework of guaranteeing such quality of service enforcement by formal analysis. So our overall approach uses as input use cases proposed by our industrial partners. So the project is a cooperation between Mälardalen University, ABB, Ericsson, ABB Robotics, Ericsson, and Volvo Group Trucks Operation in Sweden, which have a particular interest and particular use cases that actually feed our research vision with requirements, a platform description, software description, and of course data. And then our role is to look at the data, try to understand it and generate a data and quality of service model that actually takes into consideration properties, values, platform, and so on and so forth, to actually evaluate the potential risks that such a system can be exposed to with respect to safety and security. And for this, we envision using a unified ontology, hazard ontology, that actually tackles both safety and security aspects, since there is a tight interdependency between the two. And also we have, like, let's call it like a middleware, in which we look at resources and scheduling policies. So how can we actually quantify the usage of low-level resources, and how can we monitor such usage such that this information is fed into algorithms that can place applications on virtual machine dynamically and efficiently. And last but not least, all this information is exchanged also to another layer that provides an integrated formal modeling and analysis of such platforms, and with a particular emphasis on scalability. So the targeted results are a modeling framework for relevant quality of service aspects and their dependencies, efficient methods and tools for controlling the computation and communication resources provided by the industrial cloud infrastructure, and a formal modeling and analysis framework. All these targeted results are going to be validated through industrial case studies to demonstrate their effectiveness and, of course, applicability. And then experiments are going to be carried out to check the scalability of our approaches. We have some initial results that actually have been presented or are going to be presented next at this conference, which is very nice. To reduce, so we started to work on the first level, so to reduce the system level security hazards and collisions. We performed a case study on industrial fixed and mobile robots that actually are equipped with emergency stop buttons. And we developed a visibility-based algorithm for knowing which machines to stop once such a button is pressed in such a way that it is safe. And we also looked into a client-server-based approach to stop the visible moving machines when the emergency stop button is pressed. We are going to enhance the capability of algorithms to a scalable and distributed version. And this is a paper that has been presented yesterday, Those Shall Not Move, a visibility-based emergency stop system for smart industries. The next result, to enable the fine online control of hardware resources, which we hypothesize will actually give important information that will boost the dependability of our solution, we have investigated automating profiling for the low-level resources usage by applications via three steps: monitoring large sets of hardware resources with the so-called performance monitor unit, retrieving those hardware resources with higher impact on process performance, so actually identifying which of them have a significant impact on the performance, and automatically creating an application fingerprint based on hardware resources usage. This is going to be presented next by my colleague. And last but not least, in order to develop formal modeling and analysis of industrial cyber-physical systems, we study an industrial application of mobile robots that move on a factory floor discretized as a Cartesian grid. And these robots use services located on the private cloud as well on the public cloud. And we have built an initial formal model by using our previously developed timed automata-based mission planner for autonomous agents, which actually generates formal models that can be model checked and an execution plan can be generated. The next steps is to model secure communication protocols between agents and cloud, to model the virtualized infrastructure and allocation of services to virtual machines, and tackle the scalability of verification. The conclusion is that market-leading companies like our partners consider the adoption of cloud. Some already did. Some are in the process of adopting it, but they are missing the dependability guarantees that we are working on. And the initial results seem promising with respect to our goals. So we are continuing to work on this. Thank you very much.